Hi everyone, this is Jonathan. And first you will need some acid-treated graphite. That's this stuff right here. It is made by soaking graphite, and I'm using 35 mesh flake graphite for this. Soak it in some concentrated sulfuric acid and a little bit of phosphoric acid in this case. And it's basically 3/4 sulfuric acid to 1/4 phosphoric acid. You let it sit overnight, you wash it, rinse it, filter it, dry it, and you pop it in a microwave. Put it on high power, and do this outside. And I would recommend using a safe microwave that's been carefully taken apart and fixed so that all the chemical vapors and acid fumes will not corrode anything inside the microwave. And also, there's a lot of high voltages within a microwave, even when it's off. So I wouldn't do this if you don't know what you're doing. And as you can see, the microwave energy is rapidly expanding the graphite, because graphite is a good absorber of microwave energy. It's rather interesting to watch. I'm gonna do this for about several minutes till all expanded. And here's the final product. About 600 milliliters of expanded graphite. I started with 50 milliliters in this demo, and you can see that's about 12 times volume expansion, which is rather good. And at a density of 17/1000ths of a gram per cubic centimeter is very light indeed. And here's one single flake expanded out. You can see that there's millions of layers of graphene in each flake. And here's some electron microscope imagery of the expanded graphite. And here's the detail showing the individual graphene layers kind of joined together in a puffy arrangement. And also, expanded graphite shows remarkable reactivity to static electricity. Even the minutest amount of static electricity generated by rubbing your finger against a plastic bottle, you can see how it reacts. And researchers have also demonstrated a really interesting effect with lasers generating motion by inducing electric field around the graphene, and thus would be perfect for light sail spacecraft. And here's a demonstration showing 15,000 volts. You can see it arcing, and the static field generated around the electrodes also move expanded graphite. And here's some compressed expanded graphite. This stuff is very highly conductive. And expanded graphite can be useful in producing graphene. And here's a liquid phase exfoliation using some of the graphite that I've made using a microwave. Now, this stuff's highly conductive, has high surface area, and it can probably be used as is for supercapacitors and batteries. I hope you found this interesting, and I'd like to say thank you for watching.